Hi everybody, welcome to the fourth part of 10th chapter Gravitation. This is from your NCERT book of class 9 CBSE. My name is Avantika and these are the numericals that are given in the book, and I hope you have seen parts 1, 2 and 3 before you come to this, otherwise you will not understand anything. Okay, because we have solved numericals based on all the previous parts that we have seen, right? So please keep something open, keep your books open to read the questions, keep a notebook with you to solve those questions, right? And I'll be teaching you all of these step by step, so it is good that you see this video properly, alright? So the first question is, how does the force of gravitation between two objects change when the distance between them is reduced? So here we know that F is equal to gm upon square, right? So when the distance between them is reduced to half, so what do they mean? When d is big halved, then it becomes half d square, which means f is equal to gm m upon d square by 4, and then you can multiply this, so the force becomes 4 times, right? Force becomes 4 times of what it was. This is called inverse square law. I have told you about this previously. So if it is decreasing by half, then the force is increasing 4 times. Okay. Gravitational force acts on all objects in proportion to their masses. Why then does a heavy object not fall faster than a light object? Here they are talking about gravitational force, which is F is equal to mg. What they are saying is that it depends on the mass. So if it depends on the mass, why does a heavy object not fall faster than a light object? They are talking about velocity. They're talking about how the velocity changes. But you have to remember that velocity depends only on acceleration in this case. And here the g, we have derived this formula. G is equal to g into m upon r square, where m is the mass of the earth. G is it does not depend, it is independent of the mass of the object, right? So the gravitational force acts equally on all objects and it doesn't depend on the mass of the objects, and because of that the velocity that is gained, which is due to the acceleration force, acceleration due to gravity, there is no other force acting but the force of gravitation in a free fall, right? When the free fall, when there is no other force acting, it is only the acceleration due to gravity that is acting on the object, which is causing the velocity to increase, and that force, that acceleration is independent of, that acceleration due to gravity is independent of mass. Okay, that is independent of mass. Please don't get confused, kyunki F is equal to mg hota hai, ma hota hai, so A is F upon m. So you would say ki it is inversely proportional to the acceleration. In this case, we are talking about g. G is capital G into m of earth upon r square, where it is not dependent on the mass of the object. Therefore, the velocity gained by the object is not dependent on the mass. It is only dependent on the acceleration due to gravity, which is constant in this case. All right. Of course, the velocity gained or not gained depends on a lot of other factors, not just the g. But in this case, we are talking only about free fall, nothing else. Not about the, we are not talking about any other force acting on the object. It is only, we are talking about free fall, where only the acceleration due to gravity is acting. Okay? What is the magnitude of gravitational force between the earth and a 1 kg object on the surface? Mass of the earth is given and radius of the earth is given. There are two ways to solve this question. So you know that F is equal to g m m upon r square, in this case r square, because it is on the earth. And there is also one more formula, which is the same, right? This is the same force, is equal to mg. It is easier for you to just solve it using mg, because force is equal to mass is 1 kg into g is 9.8 meter per second, so force is 9.8 newton. ठीक है, आप अगर ये सारे, even if you put this mass of the earth and mass of the radius of the earth in this formula. I think you will need to solve it using this formula. Okay, please remember that when you are solving it in the exam, you should, if you have a subjective type question, you should solve it using this formula. You have to show your teachers that you know how to calculate that. Okay, but if it is only, and g ke value you should remember 6.67 capital G 10^-11. But if it is an objective type question, don't go into all of those. Just go for F is equal to mg. We have already seen that F, these two are the same, we have equated them previously, and that is how we got the value of small g, right? Ye jo formula mila. Anyway, so if you solve, you will see that you get the answer is the same in both cases, so don't worry. Okay, the force and the earth and the moon are attracted to each other by gravitational force. Does the earth attract the moon with a force that is greater or smaller, or the same as the force with which the moon attracts the earth, and why? See, the force of gravitation acting on two objects remains the same. It is the same force acting on both objects. ठीक है? F is equal to g mm upon d square, right? This is the force acting on both of them. It is dependent on both their masses. It is dependent on the distance between both the objects. So the force acting on the earth, so the earth attracts the moon with the same force as the moon attracts the earth. Okay, simple. If the moon attracts the earth, why does the earth not move towards the moon? You have seen this previously in the motion, okay, chapters force and motion, I think chapter 9 itself, that the effect of the force is different depending upon the masses, right? So force is equal to ma, so m pe depend karta hai, mass pe depend karta hai. Right, here also you will see that F depends on the mass of the objects. Okay, so higher the mass of the object, okay, please remember the mass is the same, the force acting on both of them is the same, right? So force yahan pe bhi same hai, but because the force is the same, the masses are different, the effect seen is different. Haan, you have also seen this previously, ki if you put the same amount of force on a truck and the same amount of force on a trolley, you will see that a trolley moves much faster and to a much larger distance, much higher distance than the truck. Okay, so that is why you have to remember that it is because the mass of the moon is lower than that of the earth, the moon is attracted to the earth and not the earth to the moon. This is also the case with sun and the earth. The sun and the earth, they are both acted upon by the same gravitational force. But because the force of the sun is, the mass of the sun is much higher than that of the earth, that is the earth moves around the sun and not the other way around. Okay, chal. Okay, previous example mein I forgot to tell you that it is based on the third law of, remember Newton's third law of motion, that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So the earth and the moon are attracting each other, but in opposite directions. So the force is acting on two different objects, the same force. ठीक है, ये मैं mention करना भूल गई थी. So please remember that. That is why earth and the moon, that is the why part of the fourth, the previous question, fourth वाला था जो शायद. Okay. Alright. So the next question, what happens to the force between two objects if mass of one object is doubled, mass of both the objects is the distance between the objects is doubled and tripled. The masses of both the objects are doubled. Now, F is equal to g m m upon d square, where m is the capital M and small m, we consider the masses of both the different objects. So what happens if mass of one object is doubled? It becomes F is equal to g into 2m m upon d square. So the force is doubled. Force is doubled. Okay, then we come to the second point. What happens when the distance between the objects is doubled and tripled? So F is equal to g m m upon d square. When we double it, it becomes 2d square, which is 4d square. The force is force becomes 1/4, right? Force becomes 1/4. When it is doubled, force is, and if it is tripled, inverse square law, then if the distance is tripled, then it reduces by the square of the distance, right? So if by 9, if the distance between the objects is tripled, then the force reduces 9 times by 1/9 to 1/9. Okay, the masses of both objects are doubled. Simple hai. If you just do 2m and 2m, then it becomes 4. So force becomes 4 times that of force, okay, of the initial force. Okay, what is the importance of universal law of gravitation? The universal law of gravitation can explain a lot of things. We have seen this in the previous chapter, in the previous, I think the first part of this, that the universal law of gravitation could explain a lot of things. It could explain the movement of the sun around the earth, of the earth around the sun, or of the moon around the earth. It could explain tides, right? Movement of earth around sun, or the moon around the earth. Okay, it could also explain tides. It could also explain why things fall down to the ground. So why we are attached to the ground, why we are we remain on the ground. So all these things are explained by gravity, right? What is the acceleration of free fall? Acceleration of free fall is acceleration due to gravity, where there is no other force acting on it. So it is only acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.8 meters per second square. It is the force. It is the force of gravity that is acting on an object during free fall, where there is no other force acting on it. It is only acceleration due to gravity. The answer is 9.8 meters per second square. What do we call the gravitational force between Earth and the object? Gravity. I think this should be the answer. Call it gravity, I think. Or I think we can also call it the weight of the object. Weight of the object is the force with which the Earth attracts the object. It's called the weight of the object, right? I think this should be the answer. Okay. Amit buys a few grams of gold at the poles as per the instructions of one of his friends. He hands over the same when he meets him at the equator. Will the friend agree with the weight of the gold bought? If not, why? Simple answer hai. The earth is not a perfect sphere. The radius of the earth is greater at the equator than it is at the poles, right? And G is inversely proportional to the radius. So if the radius of the equator is higher, then the G at the equator is lower, right? The G at the equator is lower, right? And if G at the equator is lower, we know that weight is equal to mg. Therefore, if the G is lower, then the weight also becomes lower. So Amit ne jo pole pe liya, it had a certain weight. It will be, weight at the pole will be lower than the weight at the equator, because G at the poles is higher than that of the equator. Weight at the poles is higher than that of the weight at the equator. So usne agar 10 gram का गोल्ड लिया होगा, इधर आके थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा इक्वेटर पे, इट विल शो हिम लेसर वेट, राइट? सो इट इज वैल्यू ऑफ जी इज ग्रेटर एट द पोल्स, देयरफॉर द वेट ऑफ द गोल्ड इज हायर एट द पोल्स, राइट? एंड एट जी इज लोअर एट द इक्वेटर, देयरफॉर वेट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज लोअर एट द इक्वेटर. ओके, why will a sheet of paper fall slower than one that is crumpled into a ball? Please remember, pichle slide mein aapne dekha tha, why does the velocity change with the mass? Why does an object not fall if it has a higher mass? This is different. Usme tha ki जी दैट इज एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द मास ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट, बट हियर इन दिस केस इट इज द सेम शीट ऑफ पेपर, दोनों का मास सेम है, बट वन ऑफ देम फॉल्स स्लोअर, वन ऑफ देम फास्ट फॉल्स स्लोअर. सो वाई डज अ शीट ऑफ पेपर फॉल स्लोअर देन दैट क्रम्पल्ड इन टू अ बॉल? बिकॉज इट इज नॉट फॉलिंग इन इन वैक्यूम. There is a certain amount of air that is present. Therefore, when there is air, there is a force of friction due to air. The air is pushing the sheet of paper up. You can also call it buoyancy, but we'll call it friction because it is not exactly ठीक है जो भी है, but इधर उधर वो sheet of paper will be affected more by the upthrust of the air and of the frictional force of the air. This ball, because it has a lower surface area, वो एकदम नीचे चला जाएगा. Therefore, the speed of the object will change. The speed of the object, the speed of the velocity of the ball is higher than the velocity of the sheet of paper because the surface area of the ball is lower. Therefore, it is affected less by the frictional force of the air. In vacuum, both of them will fall at the same speed, at the same velocity. Okay? Gravitational force on the surface of the moon is only 1/6 as strong as gravitational force on the earth. What is the weight in newtons of a 10 kg object on the moon and on the 10 kg object on the moon and on the earth? F is equal to mg. Okay, so weight of the earth is the force with which it is attracted to the earth, right? So weight is equal to mg. Weight on the earth is 10 kg into g is 9.8 meter per second square, right? So weight on earth is 98 newton. ठीक है, gravitational force on the surface of the moon is only 1/6, so g की value of moon is equal to 1/6 the value of g on earth. So यहाँ पे W is equal to mg में, where g becomes 1/6, mass remains constant. So weight on the moon is equal to mass, that is 10 kg into g of earth is 9.8 divided by 6. So this becomes 98 divided by 6 newton, which is 36, which 16.33. Newton. Okay, so this is weight in Newton. ये जो है weight in Newton of the on Earth and this is weight in Newton of on the Moon. Okay. चलो. A ball is thrown vertically upwards with a velocity of 49 meter per second. Calculate the maximum height to which it rises. Now इसमें आपको सिर्फ initial velocity दिया है. Apparently, हाँ, thrown vertically upwards, इसका मतलब u is equal to 49 meter per second दिया है आपको. V, the maximum height at which it reaches, v is equal to 0. Right? Height and acceleration due to gravity, which is acting downwards, minus 9.8 meter per second square. We have been given all of these things. It is easy for us to find the distance s. S is equal to, एक there is a formula, remember, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. इसमें हम a की जगह g लिख देंगे because it is acceleration due to gravity. Using this formula, we can just say v is zero. Therefore, minus 49 into 49 is equal to 2 into minus 9.8 into s. माइनस माइनस साइन कैंसिल हो जाएगी. यू विल सी दैट 9.8, 49 डिवाइड बाय 9.8 इज 5. अब कैलकुलेट करके देखो. सो 2s इज इक्वल टू 49 इनटू 5. डू यू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट मल्टीप्लीकेशन बाय 5 एंड डिवीजन बाय 5? बहुत इजी है, आई एम श्योर लॉट ऑफ यू ऑलरेडी नो, बट दिस इज अ ट्रिक दैट इज इजी टू डू. इफ यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग समथिंग x इनटू 5 कर रहे हो ना, तो x इनटू 10 अपॉन 2 कर सकती हूँ बिकॉज इट्स इजी टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2 एंड इजी टू डिवाइड बाय 5. And similarly, if you are dividing something by 5, you can do x upon 10 into 2. We cancel okay 5 ye ho jata hai, but it becomes easier. So in this case, what can you do? 49 into 5 is 49 into 10 is 490 upon 2. Okay, so 2s is equal to 245. S is equal to 122.5 meter. Okay, ये आ गया, ठीक है. मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन में 5 इज ईजी, ठीक है. ये s आ गया. द टोटल टाइम इट टेक्स टू रिटर्न टू द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. नाउ प्लीज रिमेंबर कि दिस इज द डिस्टेंस, दिस इज द हाइट दैट इज इट अचीव when it goes up. So it is only one way. इन्होंने time पूछा है on the other, on both to come back. What will we do? Since we have this distance, we will calculate the time it takes to go up there. So we know everything, right? We know v is equal to u plus at. हाँ, हम time easily calculate कर सकते हैं. V is equal to 0, u is 49 plus 80 is minus क्यों है? Because acceleration due to gravity is acting in the opposite direction. Minus 9.8 into t. T is equal to minus. एक second. I don't want to miss any step. It will be easier for you. 49 minus 49 is equal to minus 9.8 t. T is equal to 49 divided by 9.8 is 5. So 5 seconds. It takes 5 seconds for the ball to go up here, to reach this place. We want to see how long it takes to return to the surface. It takes the same time to return. So total time taken is 10 seconds. Okay, total time taken is 10 seconds. ठीक है, ये दोनों आंसर है आपके. ये distance, अरे यार. This is the distance and this is the time taken. All right. A stone is released from the top of a tower of height 19.6 meter. Calculate its final velocity just before touching the ground. Okay. इसमें क्या दिया हुआ है? Stone is released from the top. Released यानी it is not thrown with some force. It is released. So u is equal to 0 from a height of 19.6. So s is given 19.6 meter. Calculate its final velocity just before touching the ground. इसमें acceleration when it is thrown ऊपर नीचे जा रहा है, you know g is 9.8 meter per second square. So simple formula है, v square minus u square is equal to 2as, 2 into gs. So v square we want to find, minus u square is, u is 0, so u square is 0. Is equal to 2 into g is minus 9.8 and s is it's not minus, sorry, minus nahi hai because it is coming down. S is 19.6. so v square is equal to, what is 2 into 9.8? 19.6. so it is 19.6 into 19.6. that means it is 19.6 square. So v square is equal to 19.6 square, which is v is equal to 19.6 meter per second. This is the final velocity just before touching the ground. A stone is thrown vertically upward with an initial velocity of 40 meter per second. You know, u is equal to 40 meter per second. Taking g to be 10 meter per second square, find the maximum height reached by the stone. What have you been given? Vertically upwards. U has been given 40. V kitna hua? 0. G has been given 10. What do you want to find? Maximum height reached by the stone. Maximum height is S. So simple formula, V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. जीरो है, ओके. So v square is 0 minus 40 into 40 is equal to 2 into 10 into s. हाँ, so ये हुआ 20. So this is 80. ये minus है यहाँ पे. This is minus 10 because it is going up. So minus sign gets cancelled. Distance कभी minus में नहीं होगा. So if you have a minus sign somewhere, then you are कहीं तो अगर cancel नहीं हुआ है, then you are doing something wrong. So please check. So s is equal to 80 meter. What is the net displacement and the total distance covered by the stone? If they are only talking about going up. अगर इसे ऊपर जाने की बात कर रहे हैं, then net displacement is equal to distance. So net displacement from up down to up at the highest point is equal to distance, which is 80 meter. And the total distance covered is also 80 meter. But if the stone is coming down, which it will because of gravity, I assume that this is what they mean, that the stone will also come down. In that case, the net displacement becomes zero because it started from the ground. It is also coming back to the ground. So net displacement is zero. And distance covered is 80 meter upar, 80 meter down. So 160 meter. Okay. So if you have this, जिसमें ambiguity लग रही है ना आपको question में, you can just say कि you can just write this sentence. If the stone, if only calculating the distance from the ground to the highest point, the net displacement is 80 meter. The total distance is also 80 meter. But if the stone is coming down, which it will due to gravity, then the net displacement becomes zero. Total distance covered is twice because it goes up and comes down, so 160 meter. Okay. Calculate the force of gravitation between the sun and the earth and the sun, given that the mass of the earth is this much, sun is this much, and the average distance between two is this much. Okay. Now F is equal to G m m upon b square. ये फॉर्मूला पता है आपको. फोर्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट. वी नो जी इज 6.67 10 रेस्ट पर माइनस 11. ओके, मास ऑफ द अर्थ या सन कुछ भी ले लो, 6 इंटू 10 रेस्ट पर 24 इंटू 2 इंटू 10 रेस्ट पर 30. डी स्क्वेयर 1.5 इंटू 10 रेस्ट पर 11 स्क्वेयर. नाउ इसमें व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू, फर्स्ट I am going to take all the tens, rest to power जो है ये सब मैं एक साइड पे ले लूंगी, and I am going to solve the value of 10 first, क्योंकि बाद में ये बहुत complicated हो जाता है. okay, so I am going to separate these. I am going to do f is equal to 6.67 into 6 into 2 upon 1.5 square into 10 raised to minus 11, 10 raised to 24, 10 raised to 30, upon 10 raised to 11 square. 10 raised to 11 ka square kitna hua? 10 raised to 22. So this becomes 22. Okay, 10 raised to 22 hai ye. Okay, so I am going to solve this first. Isme kya hoga? Firstly, powers when they are multiplied. 10 raised to power ये जो multiply होता है, then the powers get added, right? So it becomes 10 raised to power minus 11 into 10 raised to power 24 plus 30 is 54 upon 10 raised to power 22. Then what am I going to do? Then I am going to ये again add होगा, पर इधर minus sign है, तो it becomes 54 minus 11 43. So this becomes 10 raised to power 43. upon 10 raised to power 22. When divided होता है, then subtract होता है, right? So this is 10 raised to power 43 minus 10 raised to power 22. So this entire becomes 10 raised to power 21. ये tens का solve करके हमें ये मिला, okay? Then we are going. I am going to solve these. F is equal to 6.67 इंटू 12, 6 इंटू 2 इज 12, अपॉन 1.5 स्क्वायर कितना होता है, व्हाट इज 15 स्क्वायर, 225, राइट, 15 स्क्वायर इज 225, सो वन डेसिमल प्लेस विद द स्क्वायर इट विल हैव टू डेसिमल प्लेसेस, सो 2.25, ओके, सो 6.67 इंटू 12 डिवाइडेड बाय 2.25, दिस इज 35.57, ओके, इंटू 10^21, ये मत भूलना, ठीक है। अब इसका आंसर क्या हुआ, फाइनल आंसर, इसका फाइनल आंसर इज 35.57 इंटू 10^21, और यू नो दैट व्हेन यू हैव टू एक्सप्रेस दिस, आपको ये वन डेसिमल प्लेस इधर डेसिमल फर्स्ट डिजिट के बाद आना चाहिए, सो एफ इज इक्वल टू 3.557 इंटू 10^, सिंस हमने ये इधर ऐड किया इट बिकम्स 22, सो दिस इज द आंसर, फोर्स इज 3.557 इंटू 10^22 न्यूटन, इतना हाई फोर्स है बिटवीन द सन एंड द अर्थ, राइट, दैट इज व्हाई द अर्थ इज सो अट्रैक्टेड टू द सन एंड मूव्स अराउंड द सन, ओके। चलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, अ स्टोन इज अलाउड टू फॉल फ्रॉम द टॉप ऑफ अ टावर 100 मीटर हाई, 100 meter, and at the same time another stone is projected vertically upwards from the ground with the velocity of 25 meter per second. Calculate when and where the two stones will meet. Now we assume that ye yahan pe kahin pe meet karega. Let's assume that, theek hai, so we consider this distance from the ground, we consider it to be s, let's consider it to be s, ki from the ground it reaches, it meets at s, so ye jo distance hai from the ground, if this is s, how much is this, 100 minus s, okay, so what we will do is we will calculate this distance and we will calculate this distance, okay. Now I have told you in one of the previous videos, जब दो find करने होते, you don't know S and you don't know T. What you do is, you take one of them in the others के term, other के term में उसको express करो. I'll tell you now how it to do. Now you have to see when and where they meet, which means you have to find the distance of this point, you have to find S and you have to find the T at which they meet. So what are you going to do? You're going to calculate both of them separately. Now S is equal to UT plus half AT square. ये consider करो. These have both these T and S दोनों हैं. So in the first case, in this case, जहाँ पे वो ball नीचे आ रहा है, what is the distance that is covered to reach this point? 100 minus S. है ना? ये distance cover किया है the ball that is coming down. Okay? Is equal to UT. U is zero because it is just allowed to fall, it is not thrown from the top, so U is zero, T becomes zero, so this is half into A is 9.8 into T square, so it becomes 4.9, okay, 100 minus S is equal to 4.9 T square, right, so minus s is equal to 4.9 t square minus 100, what do we do, minus sign nikalne ke liye we exchange these, okay, so s is equal to 100 minus 4.9 t square, ab isme kya hua, s ka sign nikal gaya, t ka sign negative se positive ho gaya and t square ye jo iska tha iska sign positive se negative ho gaya. You have done this many times, I just keep revising it because sometimes the confusion ho jata hai. So this you get S. Now you find S from this. Ye jo niche se jo throw kiya hai, uska distance lete hai. But when it is thrown from the bottom, it is given a certain initial velocity and that distance that it covers is S. Hai na? S distance cover karta hai to meet the stone. meet the others two, na? So S is equal to ut plus half a t square, where u is ut plus half a t square. S is equal to u is 25 into t plus half into acceleration due to gravity is minus t square. Okay, so S is equal to 25 t minus 4.9 t square. ठीक है, दीज आर द टू इक्वेशंस दैट यू हैव गॉट फॉर एस. नाउ एस एंड एस यू हैव बोथ ऑफ देम इक्वल. एस इज इक्वल टू दिस मच एंड एस इज इक्वल टू दिस मच, सो वी कैन इक्वेट. फॉर एग्जांपल ये वन है, ये टू है, वी इक्वेट दीज इक्वेशंस, टू इक्वेशंस दैट वी हैव गॉट. सो वी गेट 100 माइनस 4.9 टी स्क्वायर is equal to 25t minus 4.9t square. Now you have this common on both sides with the same sign, so just cancel them. You get 25t is equal to 100, t is equal to 4 seconds. So they will meet when? They will meet after 4 seconds. 4 second ke baad ye milenge. Okay, now you have t is equal to 4 seconds. Now you can put the value of these in any of these other formulae that you had received earlier. Now I'm going to just rub this so it is easier. We have more space. Okay. Now we put this t is equal to, we take we can take 100 minus 4.9 t square. So इधर नहीं लिखा 100 s is equal to 100. अब नहीं, we have to calculate s also because we have to calculate where they meet. So s is equal to 100 minus 4.9 t square, where s is equal to 100 minus 4.9 into t square is 4 into 4, right? 16. So 4.9 into 16 is 78.4. s is equal to 100 minus 78.4. S is equal to 100 minus 78.4 is 21.6 meter. So they will meet at a distance of 21.6 meter from the ground. From the ground. ठीक है, from the ground ये जो हमने discuss किया है, it will they will meet at a distance of 21.6 meter from the ground after 4 seconds. ठीक है. A ball thrown vertically returns to the thrower after 6 seconds. उसको vertically throw किया है and it returns to the, यानी ये दोनों journey जो किया up and down, time is equal to 6 seconds. But this is 2 into time. क्यों? Because ऊपर जाने का time is t consider and नीचे आने का time is also t. So ऊपर जाने का time is 3 seconds, नीचे आने का time is also 3 seconds. ठीक है? This is it. Okay, the velocity with which it was thrown up. Now, what all do we know? We know the time it took to. Now, we velocity with which it was thrown up. So, we need to find u. We know v at the highest point is 0. We know g is 9.8 meter per second square. In this case, g is minus. So, we need to find. We have t also, right? So, we can use v is equal to u plus at का formula. So t 3 seconds कैसे आया? Because it goes up and comes down in 6 seconds. तो ऊपर जाने का time is 3 seconds, नीचे आने का time is 3 seconds. So u 0 is equal to u plus at. U is हमें find out करना है. So minus u is equal to minus 9.8 into 3. Okay, so u is equal to 9.8 into 3, which is 29.4 meter per second. This is the initial velocity with which the ball was thrown up. Okay, the maximum height it reaches. Now you have all these values. Now you have to find s. We can use v square minus u square is equal to 2gs. Okay, v square is 0 minus u square is 29.4 into 29.4 into 2 into 9.8 is equal to 2 into 9.8 minus 9.8 into s. Now you know that 9.8 into 3 is 29.4. We can just cancel it. Minus sign bhi cancel ho jayega, ye 3, right? So 29.4 into 3, 88.2 upon 2 is equal to s. So s is equal to 44.1 meter. This is the maximum height that it reaches. Its position after 4 seconds. Right? Its position after 4 seconds. Now we consider its position from the origin. Humne origin se dekha hai, kyunki it is said that it returns to the thrower after 6 seconds. So we are considering the position from the bottom. Now 4 seconds mein kya hoga? 3 seconds mein ye upar yahan pe pahuncha and then 1 second it comes down. Hai na? So now we know that upar jane ke 3 seconds mein it has covered 44.1 meter. Now we consider ki wo 1 second jo additional hai, jo 4 seconds ka hume hai, to 1 second mein wo kitna distance cover karega. In this, what all do we know? Upar, sabse upar gaya and then it started to come down. Sabse upar gaya tab uski velocity kitni ho gayi thi? 0. It has started to come down, which means the initial velocity in this case is 0. मैं पेन चेंज करती हूँ. इनिशियल वेलोसिटी बिकम 0. ठीक है, फाइनल वेलोसिटी की जरूरत नहीं है. वी नो जी इज इक्वल टू 9.8 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. वी नो टाइम इज इक्वल टू 1. हाँ, 1 सेकेंड हमें बस देखना है कि वो कितना नीचे आया. हाँ, वी जस्ट वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द डिस्टेंस. सो वी यूज दिस, एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वायर. इसमें जी टी स्क्वायर हो जाता है, विच इज द सेम थिंग. U is 0, so this becomes half into 9.8 into t square is 1 into 1 is 1. ठीक है, so s is equal to 4.9 meter. Now its position after time t, you have been asked the position and not the distance it covers in 4 seconds. You are asked the position. You are asked the position from the bottom. नीचे से. सो वॉट विल यू डू? ऊपर गया 44.1 मीटर एंड नीचे आया 4.9 मीटर. सो पोजिशन कितनी हुई? 44.1 माइनस 4.9. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड? 44.1 माइनस 4.9 कैसे हुआ? बिकॉज यू आर आस्ड द पोजिशन फ्रॉम द बॉटम, तो यू आर लुकिंग एट अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो इट बिकम्स 39.2 meter. This is the position of the object after 4 seconds. So velocity with which it was thrown up, this high maximum height it reaches, and the position after 4 seconds. Okay, chalo, these are questions from within the chapter. Pat 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 karte hain, because again it's been a long video. State the universal law of gravitation. Every object in the universe attracts every other object in the universe with a force that is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay? You have to basically explain this formula, or you have to explain actually this formula. Okay? You have to एक्सप्लेन कर दो, बस बहुत हो जाएगा. दैट इज द यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन. राइट द फॉर्मूला टू फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स बिटवीन द अर्थ एंड एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. यू कैन डू बोथ. यू कैन राइट एफ इज इक्वल टू जी एम अर्थ मास ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट अपॉन आर स्क्वेयर, और यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट एफ इज इक्वल टू एम जी, वेयर दिस इज द मास ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड जी इज द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, acceleration due to gravity. What do you mean by free fall? Free fall is the motion in which an object is falls from a height to the ground only acted upon by the acceleration due to gravity. There is no other force other than the acceleration due to gravity. What do you mean by acceleration due to gravity? Acceleration due to gravity is the acceleration that an object is acted upon by due to the gravitational force of the earth. Acceleration due to gravity, you just have to explain this word. वो फ्रेज को एक्सप्लेन कर दो. इट इज द एक्सेलरेशन एक्टेड अपॉन बाय एक्टेड अपॉन एन ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज फॉलिंग अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ ग्रेविटी. एक्सेलरेशन एक्टिंग ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉलिंग अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज कॉल्ड एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी विच इज गिवन बाय द टर्म. यू हैव टू राइट दिस ऑल्सो. विच इज गिवन बाय द सिंबल जी एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज 9.8 मीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके, what are the differences between the mass of an object and its weight? Mass of an object remains constant, whereas the weight of the object, you have to give the definition. Mass of the object is its characteristic property. Weight of the object is the force with which the earth is attracting the object, hai na? Mass of the object does not change depending on the force of gravitation, whereas weight is directly proportional to the force of the gravity acting on an object. ठीक है, ये दो उसकी आपको तो है ही. Mass remains constant, weight changes with change in gravity. Okay, ठीक है, ये basically दो ही हैं. You can give the definitions also. Weight is the force with which an object is attracted, with the earth attraction object of mass m. Why is the weight of an object on the moon 1/6 its weight on the earth? Because the force of gravitation on the earth, on the moon, is 1/6 that of the earth. You are not saying that the force of gravitation between the earth and the moon, uski baat nahi ho rahi hai. You are talking about the force of gravitation between an object on the earth and an object on the moon. The force of gravity between this object and the earth is g, whereas on the moon it is g by 6, which is why weight is 1/6, because weight is the force with which the earth attracts the object and the force with which the moon attracts the object, which is dependent on the g. W is equal to mg. Give this formula. Say weight is directly proportional to the gravity, force of gravity on the object, on the earth and the moon, because g of moon is 1/6 the g of earth. Therefore weight on moon is equal to 1/6 the weight on earth. Okay, why is it difficult to hold a school bag having a strap made of a thin and strong string? It is difficult because the thrust of jaise apna shoulder hai, for example, the thrust is acting in this direction on your shoulder with the strap. So this force is acting on a very small surface area, therefore the pressure on that area is very high. If you increase the strap size, therefore the thrust acting because of the bag is distributed along that surface, therefore the pressure that is exerted on the shoulder is lower. Therefore it is difficult to hold a bag which is a thin and strong string, because the pressure acting through that small surface area of that string is very high, hai na? What do you mean by buoyancy? Buoyancy is the upward thrust. Buoyancy is also called up thrust. It is the force acting in the upward direction, force of given by a fluid which is acting in the upward direction. Force provided by a fluid acting in the upward direction is called buoyancy. It acts against gravity. Why does an object float or sink when it is placed on the surface of water? An object floats or sinks in the surface of water because of the buoyant force acting on it. When an object is less dense than the density of water, then it will float on the surface of the water because the buoyant force acting on the object is higher than the gravitational force acting on it, and it will sink when the density of an object is higher than the density of water. Then the object will sink because the buoyant force acting on the object is less than the force of gravity or acting on that object. Okay, so this is all that we have learned. I am not going to read this out. We have already spoken about all of these things. This is just a summary of the entire chapter, and it is important that you read all of this. Agar aapko kuch samajh nahi aaya, please go to those parts again. And I think we have spoken about this in part 1. We have spoken about this in part 2. This is also part 2. This is all part 3. ठीक है, ये हमने ऐसे parts में discuss किया. If you have not understood any of these points, please go and watch that video again. Okay? If you still want us to explain something, please comment, please write to us on the email given below. If you like this video, please give us a like here, please give us a thumbs up, please share it with your friends, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you get notified every time we upload new videos. Okay, for now I'm going to bid you goodbye, and I'm going to see you in the next chapter. All right, so for now, bye, see you.